for the last time this season. I am Nathan Judah. That is Mr. Timothy Spears. We are at Anfield. Tim, Liverpool 2, Wolves 0. Wasn't a classic game by any means, but at the same time, look, job done, isn't it? It's been a great season.
Job done, not job done today, but however, I'm not sure there's much more they could do except for put the ball in the back of the net, really. I mean, I spoke to a few of the players, characteristically disappointed that they've not got a point here against a team that's earned 97 points this season, almost a perfect season, lost one game, they're in the Champions League final, and Wolves come away disappointed.
That's a standard they set themselves.
Not got a result, which is entirely within their character. And they probably just about deserve one. I mean, what I would say is that Liverpool basically stopped playing after a really weird,
strange
5-10 minutes in the first half where we thought Brighton had scored. They hadn't.
Then Brighton, Man United had conceded.
Yeah, then Brighton did score. Then Man City equalised. All sorts of noises going on here. When Brighton did score, it was like a last minute winner in here.
Yeah,
it was like uninhibited, crazy celebrations. People were falling over the stairs.
Oh, it's mental.
John Barnes was going absolutely crazy in the posh seats. It was, you know, they thought it was on. And it definitely affected the Liverpool players, I think. And the game kind of died as a result. And Wolves finally, after a sheepish opening half an hour, got a foothold in the game, nearly equalised just before half-time where they hit the bar. And then second half, I think Liverpool, knowing that City were 3-1 up, I think they kind of knew it's not happening, and Wolves almost took advantage of that, and they created several opportunities. It was one-way traffic.
Oh, it was absolutely second half. Midway through the second half, it was absolutely superb.
Yeah, which is why they're disappointed that they didn't get a result.
Yeah, and just disappointed they conceded so early in the game as well.
Yes, with the quality that Liverpool got and needing a win today, they're always going to create chances, and you wouldn't really put the finger at anyone really for either goal. Trent Alexander-Arnold,
not a bad player, is he?
Second best right wing back in the league this year.
Second best.
Two deliveries on a plate for Mane, who's obviously joint top scorer. He's not going to miss those, but you wouldn't really point the finger at Wolves' defence for those two. Playing such a good team, Liverpool, the only team that really schooled them this season. Back at Molineux, so it's always going to be a tough ask. And it transpires that Liverpool are only the second team to do the double over Wolves this season. Who's the other one, Nathan?
Shuddersfield.
It's crazy, isn't it?
It is crazy. But look, like you say, second half they had plenty of chances. I thought they pressed higher up the pitch.
Yeah, they did.
And and Doc had plenty of joy down this right hand side.
He was immense. He got in behind Andy Robertson time after time after time again, and put some good balls on a plate. Jimenez spurned a good opportunity.
Yes.
Jota, again from Doherty's lofted through ball. We don't see too many of those from Doc, but that was perfect. Jimenez, one of two really good dummies, clever dummies that he played today. And Jota was in, and Alisson, great keeper, comes from his line to smother. And of course, Doherty hit the bar in the first half. So you've got three really good chances there, a few more half chances. Just a shame, in front of, no doubt, their biggest global audience of the whole year.
Yeah.
And probably therefore ever.
Yes.
It's
true.
Probably won't be able to quantify that and get the actual stats, but I can't imagine that there's been a bigger TV audience watch a single Wolves game than today. But they put on a show, and they showed the watching world, you know, what they can do, really. Just couldn't quite get that goal.
The press conference room was absolutely packed for Nuno afterwards. Nah. Packed. Have you seen it?
Yeah, I've seen it.
Oh, it's a great show. Just put little Joe Edwards and Nuno there.
Joe Edwards granted an exclusive interview with Nuno today. The only man who gave a damn to speak to the Wolves manager afterwards. Obviously, yeah, it was all
about... He spoke in Spanish.
why did he speak in Spanish?
No, a couple of hacks at the back, I think, of the Spanish media, so just spoke in Spanish, yes.
Obviously, you know, from a neutral point of view, it was all about Liverpool today, but Wolves played their part in decent contest.
No, but Tim, it's been a pleasure covering them this season. It's been unbelievable. Yes. And look, they've still got one eye on a certain game next weekend as well.
One eye. Two eyes.
Two and a half. Three eyes.
Oh, goodness me. Yeah, the season is over, but it's not.
Mm.
So all eyes now turn to Man City, who, if anything's... if today's anything to go by, won't have too many problems beating Watford. You know,
Watford were terrible.
Well, and Olibas was sent off. Yeah. Shock. So now misses the final.
Did he miss the final? Did he go across to the FA Cup, does
got
it?
Sent off in a dead rubber.
He's not in the league.
Well, but Bolly got sent off in the league and missed the cup. So
I love that.
All eyes turn to Wembley next Saturday, 5:30 kickoff. And if Man City win, Wolves are in Europe.
And they do deserve it, don't they? There's been some amazing, amazing highs this season. Not too many lows, really.
Apart from that spell of 5 defeats in 6 last autumn.
Mm-hmm.
and obviously the semi-final, but still, you've got to look at it as to get to a semi-final. Anybody would have taken seventh and cup semi this year.
Yeah.
It's been a phenomenal season. More enjoyable even than last year. More of an achievement even than last year. We thought it could be top. 99 points. They've stormed to the championship title.
Yeah.
And they've got even better this year. So my question is, where the hell do they go from here? What is next?
Kazakhstan away.
Yeah, well, we'll see. And do you know what? They'll take it all in their stride. If they're in Europe, they'll embrace it. They'll take on that opportunity. They'll
strengthen.
Well, everyone goes on about the squad size, but I'm not going to fixate on that too much. You know, Nuno likes a smaller squad. Got good under 23 players. They'll make signings in the summer. They'll be ready.
Yeah.
They do, as we know, they do take it one game at a time. Mm-hmm. They take it all in their stride, and we've seen that this season. And if they're in the Europa League and they've got six games to play before the end of August, then they'll cope with it. They'll cope with it. This is the fittest squad I've ever seen in my life.
Yeah, they're incredible. Yeah.
They've had four injuries all season. None for months now.
No.
He's had a fully fit squad to choose from for months. They're obviously, in the absence of some kind of voodoo magic, right, that's going on behind the scenes at Compton, they obviously know what they're doing as far as injury prevention goes. That's a massive part of what we've seen this season. And the work they do on the training grounds, small squad, clearly benefits them. So I'm not going to worry about Europa League. You know, they'll embrace it, spring it on.
And they will be desperate to get on holiday, but they can't because they've got the Wolves End of Season Awards on Tuesday night.
End of Season Awards,
we shall be there.
Matt Doherty's going on an international training camp with Ireland.
Oh, he loves that, loves that band. He's buzzing.
They're all going here, there and everywhere.
He might even smile.
Vinagre's in the Under-20 World Cup with Portugal. Lots more of them will be called up over the next few weeks.
Mm-hmm.
It's not a huge break for some. Then they go to China. In the middle of July, so it's but this is it. This is it.
This is what success does to you.
Exactly. And like I said, they will embrace it. But first of all, as you say, it's the end of season awards on Tuesday.
On Tuesday, me and Tim shall be there. We might be doing a little post-match video, and we might even do another video at some point next week. But we'll let you know about that in a few days' time. For the last time this season, Tim Spears, Nathan Judah.
Until Tuesday.
It's in a game situation.
Okay.
Liverpool 2 Wolves 0. For all the post-match reaction, make sure you log on to Express and Star. .com